Well, I got some good news and I got some bad news. The good news is we got a really nice giant forest hog. The bad news is we shot it late in the evening and we were so busy celebrating and taking photos, we ran out of light to do video. So this is kind of a follow-up. The giant forest hog is an extremely unique animal, and I don't know of any better person to explain what a giant forest hog is than Christoph Morio, who has probably put more clients onto giant forest hog than any other PH in Africa. And Christoph, can you tell us a little bit about what's unique about a giant forest hog?
First of all, Mark, I want to say congratulations, because it was not an easy hunt with a pistol.
No.
Okay. And but finally, we got that nice giant forest hog. So, you know, that giant forest hog, I think here in that corner of Central Africa, there are a lot. The density is very high. You know, as you can see, during the hunt, we saw quite a few sounders, mm-hmm. and we could have get quite close from them, and which give to that area a hunt. We can really hunt them on purpose, I mean.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
That's correct.
So those giant forest dog, the boars, the older boars, they used to live on their own. Okay? So mm-hmm. you can find them just alone, or you can also find a big sounders. Up to 20. I saw up to 20 giant forest dog together, you know. Wow. And then in those big sounders you can find 2-3 boars, always a bigger one, of course, because, yep. you know, when they get the same size, they fight and they chase each other.
Right.
So there's a dominant boar in a sounder, and then you have 3-4 big sows, and then the offspring, and the one of the year before. And so sometimes it gets quite a big group of giant forest dog, you
sure.
know. And
well, you know, you mentioned that there's a density of forest hogs in this area. Really, giant forest hogs are not spread throughout Africa. There's a very few of them in Cameroon. There's a very small pocket in Ethiopia. And right here in Central Africa is really the only place you can get giant forest hog. And there's probably, like you said, a good density, a good population of giant forest hog
this
region.
Yes, right. Yes,
yeah.
right. You can hunt them on license, okay,
right.
in Ethiopia, which I think they are the biggest over there, you know.
Huge.
On the body size and trophy size. I mean, if you check on the book, all the biggest are coming from Ethiopia.
Right.
But then you have Cameroon, where you can hunt them on the license.
Right.
And Central Africa, you know.
Sure.
But there's some in Uganda, there's some in Congo, there's
okay.
some, you know, in the forest, yeah. Central African forest there, you can find some.
And they live in the forest.
They do live in the forest, but here, In this country, in the eastern part of Central Africa, you have that famous biotope, which is a mosaic of savanna, which
yes.
is quite thick,
mm-hmm.
and those forest galleries, you know. Every 5 kilometers you find what we call here bako,
yes.
and those big forest galleries where there's bongos and yellowback and bay diker, west diker,
yeah.
blue dikers, and those big pigs, you know. And you know, they can spread up a lot because, you know, when they breed, they go from one bako to another bako and make another sounder
sure.
and another sounder, and they get a lot. They
sure.
get a lot, yeah.
Well, you know, one thing you pointed out a while ago is we were purposeful hunting this animal. This is one of our priority animals.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of giant forest hogs are taken as opportunities. You know, we're hunting something else and you bump into a giant forest hog and you take it. We were hunting giant forest hog on purpose. So what was a little bit about the strategy of what we were looking for?
Yes, for sure. Here it's much easier. I don't know the other country because I've never been there hunting giant forest hog. But here you can really, really, really hunt them on purpose.
Yes.
You know, and the first thing you have to know and you notice, you know, it's they are diurnal.
Yes.
They live in the daytime,
right.
okay?
Right.
And for me, the best time to hunt them, it's between 10 o'clock in the morning up to 5 o'clock in the afternoon, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, those giant forest dog, they come often to the salt lick. So we have salt licks in the bako, in the forest, okay?
Right.
But we also have salt licks in the savannas, you know?
Right.
And we also have some pictures of Lord Derby Elan and giant forest dog together on the Salt Lake, you know,
incredible.
At midday.
Incredible.
It is quite incredible, you know. So they move a lot from the forest to the savannah, you know.
Okay.
They go to the salt and then they feed in the savannah also, you know, going back to the forest.
Right.
And they also like to feed on those big meadows we can find sometimes in those forests, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know, they go there and then, or you go from one to another, or you just wait. You sit and wait in those big meadows where they like to eat that special grass we find
right.
here, you know.
Right.
And or also just on the water, okay.
Excellent.
On the small rivers with mud, and they of course like all the pigs roll in the mud, you know.
Right.
And so you can, you know, sneak and look and, you know.
Sure.
And also you can also track them.
Excellent.
When they're outside of the forest, you know, you can track
Follow
them.
The
yes,
yeah.
sure.
Well, I tell you what, this is a very unique creature. This has been an incredible adventure. The giant forest hog was one of our priority species, and thanks to you, we got to take this one to the salt.
Yeah.
It's really an adventure hunting in Central Africa. The hunting is not easy. It's hot. There's a lot of walking. But I can tell you the rewards are certainly there, and we've really enjoyed this experience. We took this giant forest hog with a Freedom Arms 44 Magnum pistol, and thanks to Christoph, we've had an absolute wonderful adventure here in Central Africa. Thank you, Christoph.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you.